Okay, go ahead.
All right, Brendan Taylor here, True School Sports. I'm with, on the phone, we got his manager, Juan, and we got El Gallo, Juan Francisco Estrada, before his big fella Chalatito. How you doing, Gallo?
Muy bien, contento y ansioso ya con todos los días bien, y estoy motivado por estar a pelear.
I feel very motivated and happy that the fight is around the corner. And overall, I'm just very excited for it.
Yeah, I'm excited for it myself. It's been a long time coming, so I don't want to waste any time. I want to just get straight into it. What I wanted to ask Gallo is, it's been 9 years since the first fight, so he's had a lot of time to reflect. What does he remember about the first fight with Chocolatito?
Dice el reportero que él también está muy emocionado y ansioso por la pelea. Que ya son cerca de 9 años de la primera pelea que tuviste con Chocolatito. ¿Qué reflexiones tienes de esa primera pelea y qué te acuerdas de la primera pelea?
Bueno, yo creo que mucha gente está ansiosa por esta gran pelea, ¿no? Mucho tiempo de espera. Y pues la verdad que espero una guerra, ¿no? Yo creo que va a ser una pelea mejor que la primera y pues aquí vamos a demostrar, ¿no? Que tenemos para ganarle a Román González y pues en un peso que se adapta mejor a mí.
He said he feels like a lot of people are excited about the rematch because it's taken so long to get the rematch. He recalls that the first fight was a war. His reflection is that he believes the second fight will be another war, maybe even better. What he sees as the difference between the two fights is the weight division, and he feels that this new or the rematch being at this new weight division of super flyweight is gonna help him a lot more.
Absolutely, man. And his body's had some time to mature as well. So yeah, I could see that. Yeah. You know, with him, with Gallo, he seems to do like he seems to really figure out his opponents in the rematches. Cause like when he fought Juan Carlos Sanchez, he stopped him in the rematch, and then he fought Rumvasai and he put on a masterclass performance. So what I wanted to ask him was, what does he feel changes from when he fights someone the first time to when he fights him the second time?
Dice Juan que él nota que eres muy exitoso en revanchas. Por ejemplo, en tu revancha contra Juan Carlos Chupito Sánchez, lo noqueaste. También en tu revancha con Rumbin Kang, le ganaste. ¿Qué es lo que crees que te ayuda en la revancha para mejorar y ganar las peleas?
Bueno, más que nada, yo quiero demostrar que siempre, por ejemplo, en la pelea con Chupito Sánchez, nos íbamos mal, ¿no? Nos distraímos. La pelea con Román González, el peso nos afectó. Rumbisay, que también igual nos íbamos bien preparados por algunas lesiones. Y pues en las revanchas demostramos, ¿no? Gracias a Dios, no hay lesiones en esas segundas peleas. Y pues en esta ocasión es diferente, ¿no? También el peso pues ya es favorable para mí. Y pues bien preparado, yo creo que puede demostrar.
He feels that the reason for his effectiveness in rematches is because those fights that you mentioned, he was dealing with a couple of issues, and in the rematch he wasn't, so he's able to perform the way he wants to perform. For the first fight against Rumbisai, he actually had a couple of injuries that didn't let him fully prepare, and so in the rematch he didn't have those issues, so he was able to prepare the way he wanted to and beat him. And he also feels that for rematches, he feeds off of a big motivation because it's an opportunity to prove that he is the better fighter.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, man. And he really shows his boxing IQ off by how he's able to adjust in the rematches. You know, I wanted to ask Gallo as well, like, how does he feel he's matured since the first Chalatito fight? And from his perspective, what does he feel makes him such a great fighter himself?
Juan, hablando del tema de la madurez, ¿cómo crees que has madurado tú como peleador desde la primera pelea? Y
¿qué clase de beneficios crees que te da esa madurez?
Bueno, sin duda, yo creo que son casi 9 años de experiencia lo que ha pasado y pues me siento muy muy contento porque pues he logrado 3 títulos a nivel mundial y pues yo creo que eso, ¿no? Que he peleado con peleadores de calibre y eso es lo que me ha ayudado a sobresalir sobre otros rivales.
He feels that 9 years is obviously a long time. In those 9 years, he's very happy for everything he's accomplished since the first fight. He's been able to beat great fighters and win world titles. And so he feels that the 9 years of experience make him a much more mature fighter. And he's just very excited because it comes at this time and he's ready.
Absolutely, man. And he's made a lot of improvements over that time. You know, he's a great fighter himself, but Chalatito's also a great fighter. When he fought him the first time, from his perspective, what does he feel makes Chalatito such a difficult opponent to beat in the ring?
Dice que tú eres un excelente y gran peleador. A la misma vez, Chocolatito González igual es un excelente y gran peleador. ¿Qué es lo que crees tú que lo hace a él el gran peleador que eres?
Bueno, yo creo que su récord lo avala, ¿no? Sus campeonatos, la disciplina, ¿no? Yo creo que la disciplina es lo que saca a un peleador adelante y pues él ha tenido, por eso ha tenido los campeonatos que tiene. Y pues yo creo que eso, ¿no? La disciplina es lo ha sacado adelante.
He said that all we have to do is look at Chocolatito's record to get an idea of how great of a fighter he is just by looking at his career. It seems like Chocolatito is a very disciplined fighter. He speaks a lot about his discipline, and he believes that because of his discipline and his boxing ability, he is such a dangerous and good fighter himself, Chocolatito.
Absolutely. This fight's getting a lot of attention right now, and you know, for a long time, the smaller weight divisions didn't get a lot of attention. For people that are going to see Gallo try to fight for the first time on Saturday, what would Gallo like the people out there to know about just who he is as a fighter?
Dice que esta pelea está recibiendo mucha atención de los fanáticos. Normalmente los pesos chicos no reciben tanta atención. En esta ocasión sí va a haber buena cantidad de gente viendo la pelea. Para la gente que va a mirar pelear al Gallo Estrada por primera vez, ¿qué te gustaría que mirara esa gente de ti?
Bueno, yo creo que mucha gente pues ya son años de espera y mucha gente que pues no me ha visto pelear. Espero que vean a un Gallo Estrada con buen boxeo, ¿no? Un corazón de guerrero mexicano y pues más que nada una bonita pelea para todos.
He believes one of the reasons why it's receiving so much attention is because of the 9 years of build-up since the first fight. As far as the people that are going to watch him fight for the first time, he says that he would like to show that he's a Mexican warrior with a big heart and obviously display his technicality and boxing ability.
Yeah, man, he's one of those Mexican fighters that has all the skills. He's like a kind of like in the mold of like a I look at him as like a Eric Morales or a Marquez type of fighter.
Sí, dice Juan que definitivamente eres un peleador mexicano con grandes habilidades. Él cree que estás a nivel de un Eric Morales o Marco Antonio Barrera.
Yeah,
he said thanks for those comments. He feels that this fight will keep pushing him towards being a Mexican boxing figure.
Absolutely, man, and I think he really deserves it, man, because Gallo was one of those fighters that he's fought so many tough opponents. You know, he fought, obviously Chalatito, then he fought Valoria, and then Milan Milando, and Segura, and Cuadras, and the list goes on and on. So I have a lot of respect for just his career and the path he's taken.
Dice Juan que esas comparaciones a esos otros grandes peleadores te lo has ganado tú, y no hay nada más que mirar tu récord y tu carrera, y ahí se dan cuenta de que has peleado con peleadores muy duros como Viloria, Camilán Melindo, y muchos otros, por lo cual todo lo que la atención que tienes, pues te la has ganado arriba del ring.
Bueno, yo creo que la disciplina es lo que nos ha llevado a donde estamos, y pues el corazón, porque a veces, como digo, no estoy bien preparado físicamente, pero el corazón de mexicano y guerrero que soy, pues sale arriba del ring, y eso es lo que a la gente le gusta, ¿no? Y pues es por eso que damos buen espectáculo.
He said that he has had a lot of tough opponents. He believes the key has been staying disciplined and also obviously showing his big heart. He's had some fights where even if he's not feeling 100%, he's had to dig deep and use his Mexican heart to win some of those fights. And he expects to continue fighting the same way.
Yeah, man, absolutely. He's fought a lot of punchers. You know, he fought Ruang Besai, he fought Segura. Out of everybody he's fought, who does he believe has the best punching power of all the opponents he's fought in his career thus far?
Ha tocado pelear con algunos peleadores de mucho poder, por ejemplo, como Ruang Besai y Giovanni Segura. En tu opinión, de todos los peleadores con los que has peleado, ¿quiénes te han hecho los que pegan más duro?
Bueno, la primera pelea que tuve contra Ryan Villoria es el peleador que más fuerte se me había hecho. Después Giovanni Segura y Rumbisai, pero sin duda Rumbisai es el que pega más duro de todos los peleadores que me he enfrentado.
He says that the three hardest punchers he faced are Brian Villoria, Giovanni Segura, and Rungvisai, and out of the three, he would probably say that Rungvisai is the hardest puncher.
Rungvisai, yeah, man. It looks like he looks like someone that that when he hits you, you know, you really feel it.
Y dice que en las peleas se nota como que cuando pega Rungvisai te lo sientes.
Sí, es un peleador que pega duro, y pues más que nada nos cuidamos de que no vaya a pasar lo que le pasó a Román González.
Yeah, he definitely hits very hard, and when I fought him, I obviously had to be very careful because of what he did to Román González in the knockout defeat.
Yeah, when Ruang Besai fought him, was there ever a moment in any of the two fights where Ruang Besai hit him with a punch and it really got his attention and he was really hurt?
Cuando en las dos peleas que tuviste con Ruang Besai, ¿hubo algún momento que te pegó y sentiste que te lastimó?
Sí, sin duda, en la primera pelea sí sentí la pegada de él. De hecho, hubo un round, no recuerdo qué round fue, pero sí hubo un round que me puso mal. Pero pues obviamente tratamos de no demostrarlo.
Actually, in the first fight, he doesn't recall the round, but in the first fight, he did get hit by Ruang Besai, and he definitely felt it. He was a little bit hurt, but he had to keep fighting and not show and recover.
Yeah, that makes sense. He had to put on his poker face. So like, Charlatito, from the outside looking in, he seems more of like a precision puncher. He doesn't really have the most power at 115, but he places his shots really well. And Ruang Besai seems to be able to have that hard thudding power. How would Gael Estrada describe Charlatito's punches as opposed to like a guy like Ruang Besai or Viloria?
Chocolatito en este peso de 115 parece ser más un peleador de precisión y tal vez poco menos de poder por la división, comparado digamos a un Ruang Besai que pega duro en esta división también. ¿Cómo se te hace tú la diferencia de pegada de Chocolatito?
Bueno, ahorita nos vamos a enfrentar este sábado y él voy a saber, ¿no? Porque pues en la primera pelea que pude poner el chilo sentí fuerte, pero pues en realidad porque yo andaba débil en esa pelea. Pero yo creo que ahora él es el que me va a sentir diferente a mí.
He says that in the first fight with Chocolatito at 108, he definitely felt that Chocolatito had a lot of power in his punches. As far as this rematch at 115 pounds, he believes that's going to work in his favor. He's not going to know the power of Chocolatito at 115 until Saturday when they fight. When they fight, he's going to find out how he feels his punches, but he's going to be prepared for whatever he brings.
Okay, no, absolutely. And should he win that fight, you know, that's going to set up a possibility of maybe a third Rungvisai fight, or potentially maybe even a fight with Julio Cesar Martinez. So what I wanted to ask him was, I know he has his fight on Saturday, and that's the main focus, but should he be victorious, which fighter would he like to fight more? Would he like a third Rungvisai fight more, or would he like a Julio Cesar Martinez fight at 115 when he moves up?
De ganarle a Chocolatito el sábado, ¿qué pelea te gustaría después? Sabe que está ahí un compromiso con Rungvisai. Ha escuchado él que tal vez Julio César Martínez subiría a Super Mosca y tal vez podría pelear con Julio César Martínez. Pero a ti, ¿qué te gustaría? Obviamente, ahorita todo su enfoque está en la pelea del sábado, pero de ganar, ¿qué es la que te gustaría a ti?
No, pero nadie va ganando esta pelea. Me gustaría unificar contra otro campeón, que eso es lo que queremos, ¿no? Yo no soy.
One of my goals, or one of the things that I've always wanted, is to unify the division.
Mm-hmm.
There's definitely a lot of options out there, and as far as who I could fight next, ideally I would like to fight another one of the champions so I can keep getting more belts.
Okay, yeah, the undisputed is always the goal, man. One of the last questions I want to ask him, because I know he's short on time, is that you know, with him, if he beats Chocolatito, he'll have beaten every fighter he's ever stepped in the ring with, and he'll really have a great his resume will even strengthen more. What I wanted to ask him was, with a win over Chocolatito, how does he feel his resume would stack up to his countryman, who's regarded as the best fighter in boxing by many, Canelo Alvarez? How does he feel his resume stacks up to his with the win over Chocolatito?
De ganarle al Chocolatito González, obviamente tienes tres derrotas, dos de ellas ya las vengaste. De vengar la derrota con González y le ganaras el sábado, obviamente tu carrera y tu récord estaría muy establecido. ¿Y cómo crees que tu trayectoria se podría comparar a otros grandes peleadores mexicanos, incluyendo a Álvarez?
Bueno, la verdad es que yo a Román González lo considero un futuro salón de la fama, y pues ganándole yo creo que vienen buenas cosas para mí, y pues yo creo que entraría en la historia del boxeo mexicano, no sé si del mundo, ¿no?, pero del boxeo mexicano por lo menos, y pues me sentiría muy contento de vengar la tercera derrota, ¿no?
He thinks that if he beats Chocolatito González, who is a future Hall of Famer, beating a future Hall of Famer, he believes would really establish his credentials a lot. As far as where he would rank after a win like that, he believes, or he wants to be known in Mexican boxing history as one of the top fighters. He doesn't know how high, because there's many great fighters. He doesn't know if on a worldwide international level he would be considered one of the top guys, but he strives to be one of the Mexican boxing idols.
Okay. Okay. I got one more question for him, but before I ask it, I wanted you to tell him, tell Gallo that I believe he's the best Mexican fighter in the world. I really believe that.
Dice Juan que ya nomás tiene una o dos preguntas más para terminar, pero antes de terminar, dice que nomás te quiere felicitar y que sepas que en la opinión de él, tú eres el mejor peleador mexicano ahorita.
Ah, ok, pues muchas gracias, y esperamos que sea esta una pelea que quede en historia, y pues que la disfrute.
Yeah, he said thanks a lot for your comments, and he hopes to put up a great fight, and you enjoy it.
Absolutely, man. Well, is there any last message that Gallo wants to get to everybody out there about his fight with Chocolatito?
¿Algún mensaje que quieras mandar a todos los fans de tu revancha?
Bueno, que no se pierdan esta pelea este sábado, que va a ser una pelea muy buena, y pues que vamos a dar todo aquí para dar un buen espectáculo y ganar primero yo.
You just tell all the fans not to miss the fight, to watch that fight. He's ready to put on a war and do whatever it takes to win it. And so just telling everybody that they shouldn't miss it because it's going to be a great fight.
All right, Gallo Estrada and Juan as manager, thank you guys so much for talking to True School Sports. I appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Muchas gracias, Gallo.
Gracias, saludos, Juan.
Thank you, guys.